What's up everyone, Arctic here, bringing you guys a brand new Gears of War 3 gameplay and commentary. I'm playing some ranked team deathmatch on the map Mercy. Mercy. Have mercy on the damn map Mercy. I play this map so much, it's ridiculous. Anyway, I'm rocking the boss, Aaron Griffin, with my Nasher that just destroyed that guy. The Major League weapon skin on that, and gold weapon skin on my Lancer. That's what it looks like there. I get a lot of questions about where to get the Major League skin. It's actually a part of the Forces of Nature DLC, so if you don't have that, you're missing out. Not only are you missing out on awesome maps, but you're missing out on some damn nice one-shots, right? You're missing out on some really nice weapon skins. The Hype skin, which is a competitive community weapon skin for Hypestation. The Major League skin, again, for Major League Gaming. Really cool. They're nice. So this gameplay, I wanted to talk about being in the zone. And I kind of thought about how I could talk about this in a way that kind of translates to you guys versus saying, oh, well, this game I was just hot, which I am pretty. This game is really ridiculous in terms of one shots. And it's just I'm just in the zone. Literally, I'm in the zone for this gameplay. But, you know, I wanted to talk about it in a way where it makes sense. So I'm going to kind of say consistency as a player, your consistency as a player, how you can improve that, and kind of just talk about that, because I think the environment that I kind of put myself into early on in my gaming career, if you will, is what has kind of made me the gamer I am today. So talking about that, I kind of grew up playing really fast-paced shooters. I played Unreal Tournament 99, PC, Dreamcast. I played Quake, PC. And then, you know, when I got my Xbox, I didn't continue. I mean, I played a little bit of UT 2K4, but my team was on, at the time, Z was on Xbox, and they were playing Unreal Championship. So, you know, I've always kind of played quick twitch, fast-paced shooters, and in my opinion, and I would imagine with the opinions of those that played those games, they would say that those games are a lot more difficult than the majority of shooters that you play nowadays. So naturally, when I play a shooter today, I almost automatically, I know what I'm doing. It doesn't take me very long to get used to the game other than learning the maps. So I can almost pick up any game and be relatively, as long as it's a shooter, be relatively competent at that game once, you know, I start playing it. So, You know, I've had questions about how long it took me to play Gears of War and how long did it take me to get good at the game. So the best way I can kind of answer that is thinking about the environment that I was in. You know, I was playing with a team at the time, VBI, which was originally Z on Unreal Tournament and stuff. But anyway, those guys were all equally as skilled or better than me at almost every single game we played, and Gears of War was no different. So when we started playing, I was already thrust into an environment where, A, these guys were a lot better than most people because, again, we grew up playing quick twitch, fast-paced shooters, which I feel like, again, are more difficult than what you're playing today. So they had a natural knack for shooters. And when we started playing Gears, we were putting ourselves in a very competitive, high octane environment where, you know, we might be playing four other guys from our team and those guys could whoop our asses just as much as we could whoop theirs. I mean, it was pretty even all the way through. So, you know, our natural progression was we started playing against each other. We got better. We got better. We got better. And then we were like, okay, we're going to divvy up the team, because at the time VBI had 25 members or so. And, we were like, okay, these four guys are going to run together. These four guys are going to run together. And we started scrimmaging internally. This is really before, I mean, game battles kind of took off with it, but this is really before, just slightly before those guys started getting hardcore into Gears. Like, this is going to be the next MLG game. And we, I mean, we were rapidly a lot better than most people just based on that environment of practicing, you know, 3, 4, 5 hours a day. Practicing strats, practicing angles, getting our shots down, learning what to do in certain situations. So after that, it kind of transitioned into, okay, we're gonna take this further. We're gonna play at a competitive level. We're gonna compete in game battles. We're gonna go to Major League Gaming. We want to be the best, so we need to play the best. And that mindset kind of transitioned over into, I mean, Gears 2, Gears 3. And so when I play this game, you know, from a rank standpoint, you know, obviously I started off in the competitive scene, but now I'm just playing kind of solo, playing by myself. The mindset is still like, I want to put myself in a situation where I can continue to either A, improve my game, or, you know, kind of stay even keel. So that's one of the reasons I like to play by myself. I feel like if you want to become a better player, you need to think objectively about how you can do that. Do you want to be a better Nasher player? I mean, honestly, watching a tips video may help you get that core understanding. But the God honest truth of how you get better is simply practice. Not only practice, but it has to be very good quality practice. And it needs to be against people that are either equally as good or better than you. That is very key. That is very, very key. And I know it could be hard for some people because they, you know, they don't have friends that play Gears of War. Whatever the case may be, you know, get yourselves involved in game battles. I don't personally like the game battles community. Those guys can be really, you know, pricks. They're assholes. Sometimes they don't really represent a very good portion of the community. But some of the guys are really good. So, you know, it's kind of a mixed bag. Those are the areas where you're going to find the people that are literally the best at the game at this present point in time, other than some of the private, you know, top MLG teams that don't really play game battles. They kind of scrimmage internally. That's the next best place to go. So if you really want to excel, you really want to take your game to the next level, again, you need to develop an objective mindset, one, but you need to develop yourself and be in an environment where you can excel, or where you can see incremental improvement. If you're playing it, if you're pub stomping all day and then you try to hop on game battles or you try to play an MLG team, you're gonna get wrecked. I mean, you're just gonna get slaughtered, because playing ranked and stomping people in ranked is not the way to improve. You need to play players that are either as good or better than yourself. So being consistent, being in the zone, that's kind of how I attribute to that. The more I expose myself to it, the better I've kind of become as a player, and the more consistent I am. So hope you guys enjoyed this commentary. Please be sure to check out the previous Running Ranked episode, as well as my tips and tactics videos, the most recent being the Mantle Kick. And until the next time, guys, I will catch you later. Peace.